Inventing the Segway, I think Mr. Dean Kamin, an American entrepreneur, might have given the world the ultimate form of personal mobility. But there's another machine that everyone in India wants to get their hands on. It's the Mahindra XUV. Recently launched, but you know what? They closed down bookings for 2 months. But thank God for small mercies. Bookings are open again, but only for 10 days. So if you want to get your hands on one, go and book it now. But now is the time to battle it out in your head. Do you want an XUV? Or do you want a Tata Ariya? Well, Shams got to compare both the cars and took this test. Take a look.
Two homegrown heroes. One has people drooling over it. The other one is still some way off. So, what binds the Tata Ariya and the Mahindra XUV 500 together? Both of them are bulky SUVs and are flagships of car makers that have done the Indian auto industry proud. In a market dominated by players from East and West, Tata and Mahindra have a standing of their own. And with these two machines, they have taken themselves a notch or two higher.
When the Ariya was launched in the Indian market, it was described by many as a bold move by the Tatas. It had the brand image in the premium segment, it had a lot of user-friendly features. But at 17 lakh rupees, it was a tad too expensive. Well now, Tata has decided to make the Ariya a lot more affordable for you. And all this only with the exception of the all-wheel drive.
Tata Ariya sales haven't been impressive. The removal of the four-wheel drive has come as a breath of fresh air for India's largest automaker. And even though it looks masculine, in terms of style, the cheetah-inspired design of the XUV has managed to impress car lovers more. While the Ariya comes across as a part SUV, part MUV, the XUV has a clear agenda, being the number one SUV in this category.
Well, there's absolutely no doubt that the XUV is miles ahead of the Ariya in terms of style. You look at the front grille, look at the door handles, the side view mirrors, the overall styling of this car leaves you really impressed. And that is probably the biggest reason why people are falling in love with this car so much.
Very clearly, a lot more effort has gone into designing the XUV. The lines all over, the position of the tail lights, as well as the front grille, all add brilliantly to the character of the car. The Ariya doesn't lag behind too much and it has also got things working for it.
Well, many people have an impression that the Ariya is just an Innova with some added features or perhaps a stretched version of the Indiga Vista. But look at this car. It has an enormous road presence and almost imposing stance. Look at these ORVMs with integrated turn indicators or these huge 17-inch wheels or even the chrome-plated front grille on the front. They all add to the style quotient of the Ariya.
Ariya is India's first crossover. Mahindra also likes to call the XUV a crossover. But a bigger challenge is to cross over from the urban to the rural buyer, and with the new design, prospects of seeing these cars on dusty village roads have become higher.
With the Vista, the Manza and now the Ariya, the country's largest automaker has come a long way from shedding the image of a taxi maker. Well, the Ariya surely is a trendsetter.
Not that XUV is not one. That is reflected in the popularity it has garnered in the market, but it has its shortcomings too.
Well, one place where the XUV falls short than the Ariya is the inner space in the car. That is because the wheelbase of the XUV is a whole 150 mm shorter than the Ariya. Also, the fact that you can't adjust the middle row of seats means that the third row in the XUV is really, really cramped, something that is not there in the Ariya.
If the idea is to carry a family of 5-7 people in comfort, the Ariya might do a better job. Only, the middle row in the XUV is a little more spacious than the Ariya. But in the latter, all three rows of seats are comfortable enough to seat full-grown adults. It offers a much better under-thigh support and has more luggage space than the XUV. From the inside, the Ariya has to be the best-looking Tata by a long margin. There are some issues with the fit and finish, but the dash design plays to the price. XUV has a bigger problem. There are switches all over, just too many of them. Plus, the entire color theme is pretty dull. Unlike the Ariya, it does not carry the elements from the exterior to the interiors. Storage space is not a problem in any of the cars, but the Ariya takes the entire concept of glove boxes to a whole new level. Get it on the road and the XUV has enormous presence. It turns heads at will and you can pick out the XUV in a sea of cars on a jammed city road. The Ariya too has a road presence, but that is more because of its sheer size.
Well, the Ariya still runs on the same 2.2-litre Dicot that powers the Safari also, but this engine is much more refined. A gear shift is more sleek, the clutch is easier to use, and the engine noise is hardly audible inside the cabin. It doesn't give you the truck-like feel you get in the Safari, but what is exactly same as the Safari are the seats. The seats could have been much more comfortable inside the Ariya.
Sadly, in terms of ride quality, it is just a case of who performs better than the other, or in this case, worse than the other. Ariya does give some comfort, but only on good roads and at high speeds. Low-speed ride in the XUV is only marginally better than the Ariya, but even here, the overall handling is anything but great.
The XUV also runs on a 2.2-litre engine, the same one that powers the Scorpio, but it's got 20 bhp more. And the fact that this car is a whole 200 kgs lighter than the Ariya means that the driver, the performance junkie in you, will enjoy driving the XUV more than the Ariya.
200 kgs is a big advantage, and that means the XUV has a better torque. The need to shift down gears is much lesser, and it is also much faster off the blocks. It takes the XUV around 12 seconds to touch 100 km per hour, lesser than the Ariya. The weight also contributes to the mileage, with the Mahindra giving about 11 km per litre in the city, and the Ariya falling short of 10 km per litre mark.
Well, even though the Ariya is meant to be driven on the road and not off it, simply because now it's a 4x2, it still is a better highway car. And that is because of its sheer size. You won't enjoy maneuvering the Ariya in the congestion of city traffic. Also, the first two gears are still a problem in terms of power, and you need them the most when you're driving in tough city conditions.
Take the Ariya beyond 2000 RPM and you start enjoying the drive. Highway cruising is a lot of fun, and overtaking other cars even more. There can't be a bigger contrast. Mahindra has opened the bookings of the XUV after more than 2 months. And an equally good car like the Ariya is hardly selling even after becoming cheaper. Perhaps then, the price is the deciding factor. Even after shedding the 4x4 tag, the Ariya still starts at 11.5 lakhs and goes up to 14.5 lakhs. Before Mahindra announced the price of the XUV, experts said it would cost in the range of 15 lakh rupees. But lo and behold, it starts 10.8 lakhs and, more importantly, stops at 12 lakhs. Even the four-wheel drive variant is much cheaper than the Ariya 4x4. Many believe the XUV merely an emotional winner over the Ariya. The latter can do pretty much everything that the XUV does, but it hasn't got people going crazy. So don't take too long to decide. The queues at Mahindra showrooms are getting longer and they'll stop entertaining you soon. In that case, there's always a Tata dealership nearby.